Hi everyone, Lisa Haven here, and I've got a monstrous report that you guys are going to want to hear the entire thing. But for starters, I want to just talk about GMOs, genetically modified organisms. A lot of the times, we get this in a majority of the foods that we eat, and sometimes we just nonchalantly grab the products off the shelf, but there are some real severe consequences that you are not being told about that Big Pharma wants to keep secret from every single one of you because they're making money. Not only Big Pharma, Monsanto obviously is a key point in that. But here's a quote that I want to start us off with, and then I'm going to bring on former radio talk show host Ronnie McMullen. I haven't had him on in a while. I wanted to bring him on again, but we've got a bang of a broadcast for you. But here's this quote. And it's from Dr. Colin Campbell, and it is that 90% of diseases can be traced to what you eat. And that is a hardcore fact that we've gotten there from Dr. Colin Campbell. But when we take that into consideration, exercise alone isn't going to cut it. And a lot of us know that. But there's so many things in which they are killing us literally by the things we eat. When 90% of it is traced to food, this is a big problem. So, Ronnie, you're my health expert over there. Are you with me?
I am. How you doing, Lisa?
Good, good. So tell me, tell us a little bit about GMOs. What are the hazards? What are the problems? What's going on?
Well, if you notice, GMOs are we kind of shorten it down. Instead of saying genetically modified organisms, and I want to really concentrate on the word organism, we just say GMOs. And what that does is kind of poo-poos the whole name so that it's not a big deal. Like, yeah, GMOs, yeah, it's not a big deal. But it is a big deal because when another organism, and let's use it a better word, foreign organism enters your organism, because we are an organism, they don't jive. So it's much like taking a pine tree and grafting in a peach tree to a pine tree. It will not take place and part of the tree will die. So this is kind of what I think Big Pharma and the whole cash cow system of medical care, they're betting on this. I think it's all connected. There is not one bit of proof that connects Monsanto to our Big Pharma, to Monsanto, to the healthcare system. But it's interesting how they all connect easily. And here's an interesting fact. 70% of U.S. foods are contaminated with GMOs and related toxins. And 5 pesticides or herbicides are ingested daily by the average American child. And here's another one. 57% of all adults in the U.S. agree that GMO is harmful to health. So now there's a study that goes out that says, oh, yeah, well, GMOs, they're actually pretty good for you. And sometimes when I do these interviews, people will go, oh, by the way, GMOs are good for you. Well, those are the people that work for Monsanto. Those are the people that work for Bayer. Those are the people that work for these. Or those are the people that don't really want to know, because what they find in those findings are based on skewed. In other words, those are Monsanto's doctors. Those are Monsanto's scientists paid by Monsanto or Bayer to come up with the findings to say, oh, by the way, this is really good. This is why when Hillary Clinton was out there doing her thing before the election, she was saying, by the way, Monsanto is great. It's wonderful. Interestingly enough, it's so wonderful at Monsanto that they do not eat their own food. That would be a question I have. So we have a huge rise. And here is a really interesting.
Let me add a little before you say that. And, you know, you're so right. I have studied a lot of what's going on in our health industry, and there's so many organizations they're paid for, they're bought off. Hillary, one of her biggest donors, Uranium One, right? And Monsanto. These are two things she was very big on. And that's one reason why I've partnered with you, because your products are not GMO infested. They're organic. Your tea, again, this is getthetea.com. You guys need to do the detox. And I'm not saying that as a sales pitch. I'm saying that simply because it helps detox your things from this junk that we're putting in our body. And when we say 90% of us get sick from the things we eat, things like your tea, and I know you got two different kinds here, will help do that. So not to stop you there, Ronnie, but I wanted to add that in because it's crucial to know there is a real battle going on for our health.
There is, and it's a lot more serious than we think. And you know, I do a lot of interviews, and obviously I'm a sponsor of your show and many others, and I talk about my products. And I think people get an idea like, oh, geez, he just wants to sell product. But you have no idea what you're playing with here by not listening to what GMOs do. Let me give you an idea. Okay, the impact of GMO foods on human reproduction has been frightening. The following have all risen sharply. Infertility. Spontaneous abortions, infant mortality, premature deliveries, testicle damage, low birth weight. This is off of GMOs. Here's one for you. Age-adjusted kidney and renal pelvis cancer incidence. So in other words, there's a high correlation between the increases in GMO and liver cancer. So this is telling you, fact on fact, that here we have an increasing liver cancer, and where's it coming from? GMOs. So this is something that the T, this is why I'm like, oh my gosh, we have no idea how important this is. The T helps take out these GMOs. Is it going to cleanse you 100%? The biggest cleansing you could do is start reading labels and don't buy it. But this is why, in fact, I'm doing a talk in February, and doing, what's really interesting about this talk is that I'm talking just about GMOs and how these GMOs are affecting us. In fact, we were talking, off air. And I thought it was interesting. My daughter's got me into this Netflix show, and it's crazy, and it's called Stranger Things. And it's like, you know, I don't want to watch that. And I watch one and watch another. And next thing you know, you're watching two seasons full because it's addictive. But in that, and I don't want to spoil it for anybody, but in that, there shows an organism. And as soon as I saw that, it was just kind of a refresher that we have organisms trying to invade our body purposely, called GMOs, genetically modified, which means man-made organisms, and changing our RNA and our DNA so that we're literally getting changed from the inside out. This is a scary issue, and this is something that doesn't have to happen. We can stop buying their products, okay? If you think you're just buying organic and that you're safe, oh, I just buy organic and we're good to go. That does not mean it's non-GMO. That means it's organic. That has to do with pesticides and herbicides. And we talked about 5 pesticides and herbicides for your children they're eating right now. So that's only dealing with the pesticides and herbicides. You have to have a non-GMO sticker that says, hey, this is a non-GMO product. Believe it or not, there are a lot of supplements out there that have GMOs. So here you have another organism going into your body. Now, let me give you an example, and I've done this on it's very interesting. So let's say, Lisa, that I say, Lisa, you know what? You need to get some time off, and let's go fishing. And you go, oh, you know, it's kind of weird. I like to go fishing. So we go fishing. We go down the local lake, and we buy some worms to put on our hooks. And all of a sudden, you look over. You're put bait in your hook, and you look over at me, and I'm eating a worm. And you go, ooh, yuck, what are you doing? Oh, I'm just, it's really gross. But I'm saying, what am I doing? I'm eating an organism. See? And when we figure an organism as living, it changes how we think. So it's like eating bugs. Would you want to go eat bugs with me? And not dead bugs. I'm talking about living bugs. Would you want to do that? No, you wouldn't. And so why would we want to put in our bodies a living organism that changes us? This is how sharply, incredibly important this information is, because, I mean, this is not a groundbreaking thing. This is something they've been doing, and it's kind of sleight of hand. This has to do with the mass media. Oh, GMOs are great. Hillary, oh, yes, GMOs are great. Yeah, the ones that are saying GMOs are great happen to have greasy palms, and they've been given money. They have been corrupted to say this stuff. And this is why we have fake news. So it's important that shows like yourself, Lisa, are telling the truth about these things and warning the people. You know, it's like it doesn't matter if it's dried food, if it's live food, if it's produce. If it is not a non-GMO product, it is infested. It has, and just imagine that food with having worms. And that was the whole fishing thing. It gives you the idea you're eating worms. But they're much smaller. They're micro. They're little. You can't see them. And they're inside this stuff. And they're changing us. And they're causing cancer. They're causing, right here, GMO and liver cancer. I mean, what more proof do we need?
True. And that's the thing. We got to always keep that in perspective. What we're putting in our bodies and what we're doing. A lot of people, you know, a lot of the complaint that I hear, well, it's too expensive. I have a family and I can't afford it. Well, when you're quoted statistics like 90% is of your health is based off of what you eat, do you really want to take that risk? And I think that's a question. And here, let's just be frank. We go out to eat. There's fast food. There's things that you're going to ingest that have GMO in it. It's kind of hard not to ingest that stuff. It's nearly impossible in our generation, which again, why I tell people get the tea, get things. If you're going to eat them, which you will eventually, make sure you're detoxing some of that stuff out of your body. Again, just another reason I love you, Ronnie, and I bring you on, because not only do you know the problems and you know what's going on, you know the agendas of Big Pharma and Monsanto, but you also have a resolution to the issue.
The resolution is really important, but let me show you that the people are waking up, okay? In 2012, there were 7 billion people, okay, that were buying organic, and in the non-GMO area in 2012 was right around 2 billion, okay? In 2015, okay, the organic routine was sitting right around 9, 10, and non-GMO was 12 billion. So people are waking up and they're saying, hey, we want non-GMO products. These diseases, just so you know, are slamming and getting into your body and taking nutrients, and they're devastating you. So when you have no nutrients in your body, you are set up to be sick. You're set up to be cancer. Oxygenating your body is so important. And I don't just try to sell product. I let you know that, boy, you need to have exercise. We need to have clean air. And just so you know, they're dumping stuff. And we've talked about this many times on your show, the chemicals that are being dumped. So if you have chemicals that are entering the water, that are entering our food, the GMOs that are going on, what is our defense? What is our defense? And that is purified water. You need to make sure you have purified water. You need to do the best. Don't breathe in some of this air. If it's really bad and they're spraying really bad, stay in that day. And then obviously you need to be taking like the tea, which is a detox. The whole idea of detox or cleansing is about getting rid of the heavy metals, getting rid of, did you hear me? Heavy metals, and getting rid of the GMOs, getting rid of the garbage, all the stuff. You do not want to make your body a breeding ground for cancer. And if you do not oxygenate, whether that's exercise or some kind of opening up with a supplement to help you oxygenate, if you don't do that, you are going to get something. And notice, Lisa, you know this one. So did you notice that the whole healthcare issue just kind of got bypassed? We put a couple little niblets inside the tax bill, but we gave people a tax cut. This is so wild. It gave people a tax cut before we give the people a healthcare system that works. Now, what are they saying? Let me tell you. I'll just interpret that for you. It says, we don't want to touch the cash cow. We'll would rather give you tax money back than to touch our precious cash cow, which is the pharmaceutical healthcare trade.
And that's what a lot of it boils down to, sadly. Big money, big pharma. There's money involved. And when you, I mean, you big always, government. Big government, you always have to follow the money trail. That's part of my job. Like, root of the problem. Let's see. Who does it boil down to? Well, this one, and this one, who just so happen to be lobbyists and the people paying, all. I had this conversation the other day with a guy that I met. He works with the tea parties here locally. And he was just saying a lot of the people don't understand the system and politics. And here's the thing. Once you get in, once you're part of that, you have to make so much money as that cabinet member. And guess who comes along? Big Pharma, their deep pockets and all the lobbyists saying, we'll give you that money, but it comes with this little, you can't say no, or you can't pass these laws against my company, my organization. And so these are the things that we're fighting on our level. And there are things, we have to start changing that. We have to start being the cash cows to our politicians, if you will, and get the lobbyists out of play here.
Well, and I think it's interesting too, so that we don't have laws coming against Monsanto or Bayer, which is now swallowed up Monsanto, we need to put our people, okay, so Monsanto people, in the U.S. government. So now we have positions in the U.S. government with the FDA and everything that are ex-Monsanto, ex-people. So this tells you how corrupt our system has gotten. But again, looking at what's going on, people are starting to say, you know what? We are going to supplement with non-GMO. We are going to supplement and eat our foods with that are organic and non-GMO. Don't just buy organic produce. Make sure it's non-GMO. Don't look at the products and say, oh, it says organic on it. I'm just going to trust it. Because let me tell you something. The big companies, okay, have gotten wise. They're like, hey, we're seeing a turn, dude. What do? I know. Just put organic on the box. It'll work. And there's no nothing because they're all corrupt. So make sure we have non-GMO stamps as well as the organic stamps. And this is something that I am doing. It's funny because I can't put organic on my product labels because of a vegetarian thing. So it's crazy. But long and short of it is there's no fillers in my product. There is no – it's all GMO free. It's organic and it will help you. And it's really important because let me tell you something. If you got a disease, you're getting pulled of all of your goods.
Agreed. Now, just in final thoughts, can you share the information, how people can get a hold of you and all of that as well, and any specials you might have?
GetTheTea.com. Again, it's always the same. GetTheTea.com. And yes, of course, we've got specials. Actually, we've got a really cool new product, which I happen to love, is the new colostrum is a mocha colostrum. So you'll think you're at Starbucks and you're not. You're getting well drinking something. And of course, we have still have about another week and a half left on the tea deal. You buy two packages and you get three. So you get one full package for free. That's a $35 savings. So it's awesome, awesome, awesome. And again, you're cleansing from GMOs. Let's say it right. You're cleansing from genetically modified organisms.
Amen to that. So yes, that's a really good deal. He's not had that yet. So buy two, get one free. If you can do that, I highly recommend it. But I will leave all the links below. Just let them know you heard it on Lisa Haven. And thanks again for coming on my channel, Ronnie. And thank again, you guys, for listening in. I'm Lisa Haven, and this is Ronnie McMullen signing out.